he likes to put himself in the category of the technician director. He is extremely methodical in his work and technically very well equipped. A unique example of his technical expertise is the palanquin race shot in Hashuni Bakir Upokotha, a long truck shot that catches the ever-increasing speed of the race in perfect synchronization with the ever-increasing tempo of the song used for the scene. That he could conceive such a long truck shot without a cut almost 40 years ago is amazing.
Certainly, I would not go for a shot which is not possible for me to take under circumstances. It's better to omit that shot than to take a bad shot. This training, this type of training I got from my science background, you see. I think every director must have a kind of, since cinema is a technology-oriented media, the director should know something about the technique of cinema and all he translates it on the square frame of the camera. So that's very important. Until and unless the man doesn't know what is a square frame, just looking through and just submit everything to the cameraman, I don't think that he can be called a good filmmaker. 50% is technique here, and 50% is art, or whatever you call it, literature. So in order to translate that literature into celluloid, the amount of technique is necessary, and director should be well equipped of that technique.
Tapan Sinha now writes and scores music for his own films, though at an early stage of his career, he worked with great maestros like Pandit Ravi Shankar, Ustad Ali Akbar Khan and others.
In 50s and 60s, in my earlier films, I had the opportunity of working with great musicians like Pandit Ravi Shankar, Ali Akbar Khan, H.D. Burman, Sachit Dev Burman, Pankaj Mallick, Hemant Mukherjee and many others. Well, in those days I used to make lyrical films, and I thought that for lyrical films they were the ideals, because they used to take from Indian classical music and they were the experts to convey that kind of music which was required in those days. And then I tried my hand on it, though I had a very limited experience or knowledge about Indian classical music. Perhaps I knew, as most of the Bengalis, they know the very elementary rags of Indian classical music. On the top of it, I had to take certain phrases from Western composer also to make it more effective, excepting, of course, Beethoven, Bach, Mozart and Tchaikovsky, because they are very well known. But apart from them, there are hundreds of other composers, and sometimes I took, even in this wheelchair, I had taken a piece of Handel, this, just one or two phrases, then I interpret in my own way, you know, mix it up with my own music and just to get the proper effect. Well, it's a kind of process, you know, when you compose a song. Now, previously there are great composers apart from Tio. Somehow, when I wrote, the influence of them came to me. I don't believe that art film or commercial film. Film is a film itself. It's a global perspective. That's, you know, what I believe. Now, there are two or three kinds of film, good, bad, or indifferent, as you say, right from the inception of this film, from 1920s or 30s. I personally feel that there are two kinds of film, as I said before. The director designs films for the audience, and there's two. The director designs his films for himself. And when he designs his films for himself, he comes out with certain experiments without bothering about the audience. But I have cared for the audience right from the beginning of my career. I think it is an absolutely futile exercise if your film is not witnessed by the people. And I am going to continue this kind of work up to the last day of my life.
In the span of four decades, Tapan Sinha has made as many as 36 films. During the period 1954 to 1970, he made 18 films. 1971 to 1980, 10 films. And 1981 to 1994, 8 films. This sensitive and socially aware filmmaker has dealt with various issues, delving deep into each and always emphasizing his concern for human predicament.
I must say that I learned a lot from him in the very beginning. He, in fact, taught me how to walk in front of a camera or in a performance. He was very meticulous in these respects. In those days, he used to take umpteen number of rehearsals for that, and he would not be satisfied until I did the right thing. In that way, he very much resembles Satyajit Ray. But Satyajit Ray never really actually teaches an actor the details of acting, or for instance, he would never teach someone how to walk. But in one respect, they have a similarity. That is, they read out their script in such a way that an intelligent actor, or one who is interested to go deeper into it, would find cues from that, would find ways through which he can approach the role.
But for the newcomers, I never allowed them, because I always I tell them that try to copy me at least for three or four, for heaven's sake, for three or four films, and then you'll develop something within yours, and then later on you can do whatever you like.
Great thing about him is that he makes his pictures very artistic as well as for the common mass, for the mass appeal. That is the thing which is very rare in people nowadays. And personally, I like him because I worked with him. I felt so easy to work with him. We had a very good rapport, understanding. I felt it very easy to work with him. And I feel that he has a way of choosing subjects. His subjects are not ordinary, like boy meets girl or anything. But he has got a subject which has some message, some appeal. And he works with a solid confidence which he gives to his workers also.
I think Tapan usually selects literary works. Even in Sagina Mahato, it was a long short story, but he recreated that story on the screen. He tried to be as accurately close as is possible to the literary work. But sometimes when he has to improvise, he does it so delightfully that it maintains and keeps its identity with the basic work. Working with Tapanda was an experience not only in terms of a performer, but also as a student of cinema. I think that he has a place of his own. He will always be placed in the front rankers of Indian picture makers.
Thank you.